Hi, I'm Hal Johnson from Bodybreak, and you normally see me giving you fitness and health tips and being very positive, and I'm going to be positive now, but you think that Bodybreak was started because of fitness. Well, it wasn't. It was started to combat racism. That was the number one reason that we started Bodybreak, Joanne and I. It happened back in April of...
Welcome back to BT Vancouver here on a Friday. Well, for over 30 years, the faces of fitness in Canada have been Hal Johnson and Joanne McLeod of Bodybreak. We now know, thanks to that YouTube video put out earlier this week, that Bodybreak was created to battle racism. Hal joins us right now. Welcome to BT, sir.
Thank you very much.
Now, we don't have time to get into all the details of the video. I urge all of our viewers to go and check it out. But some of the things that emerged were you were shooting a commercial and you were asked to stand away from a white woman because it couldn't be seen that a black man and a white woman could be together. You had a job rescinded because a network already had a black reporter. So tell me, were you initially filled with some anger that turned into positivity when you decided to create Bodybreak with Joanne?
Not really at all. You have to realize I was 32 years old at that point, and many things had happened to me up until that point. So it was just another, being kicked in the teeth situation. So you just simply get up and get going. For me, I just don't dwell on it a lot and move on to the next thing. And then that's why I thought, how can I make a difference? How can I change this scenario, this narrative, and make things better? And that's how we created Bodybreak.
And Hal, had your parents also seen racism when they were raising you as well? Was that part of your childhood?
Absolutely. When my parents got married, in 1955, in that time frame, and they lived in Philadelphia, so it was quite a bit different. My dad's black, my mom's white, and it was very, very much, much harder for them than it was certainly for Joanne and myself, or for anybody today. It's much, much, much easier, but it's certainly not perfect by any means.
And all across the country this week, there has been an outpouring of support. What's been your reaction after you posted that video?
Well, I'm extremely humbled and excited about the opportunity. And I say that excited about the opportunity in terms that it was an opportunity to talk about something like this, an opportunity to have a different idea of it for people so that they can have a conversation between people. This video came up because I had so many of my friends, my white friends, call me when things were going on, marches, and they asked me, what should I do? How can I participate? And this is, and I thought about it. I thought, well, let me shoot this little quick video. Literally, it took 10 minutes to shoot. Not a lot of thought was put into it in terms of I just wanted to tell our story very quickly and easily, and I wish I looked that young again still.
Some throwback footage there. Hal, I'm 39 years old, so I watched a lot of television in the 80s and 90s, and I basically grew up watching yourself and Joanne on the television. But as a white kid from the West Coast, when I heard about this news about the racist roots and that giving you the idea for Bodybreak, I was shocked. But when you talk to some members of the black community, they have a different reaction to this.
Absolutely. It's funny because I've done so many interviews, and the interviews that I do with black reporters or online, the comments, the 600-700 comments, so many people are shocked. Well, the people that are shocked are white people. Black reporters, they don't say that. They don't say, I can't believe that happened. Because it happens to all of us all the time. And you become not immune to it, but you have to say, oh, how can I get through this? How can I navigate this? And so that's you often have to become a chameleon in order to navigate the situation. You look what's in front of you, and you say, this is how I'm going to attack it. So I wanted to attack it from a positive perspective, because I don't think, at least I believe, you don't change the way people think unless you change them from the heart. So we've been coming into homes for 32 years. So when I said this, a lot of Canadians, a lot of white Canadians believed it, because they've been believing health tips from Joanne and I for such a long time that we're part of your family. And so that's what's shocking, is that, geez, this happened to somebody in our family. And it's been so humbling and very rewarding. And I hope to do, we do a lot of corporate speaking all across the country, and I hope to bring this message out to a lot of Canadians and just have a conversation. A lot of my white friends say, what should I do? And I say, just listen. just listen, people will be very happy to talk about this.
And there must be a tremendous sense of catharsis and relief after getting that video out there.
Well, it's like being hit with a tsunami. I think this is my 64th interview in 3 days. It's been incredible. That's a little bags under my eyes here, a little tired. No close-ups. It's been more physically demanding on me. I mean, I'm really exhausted because of the emotion and telling this and talking about it, which I want to do. I want to do this, and I'm thinking about the next video that we should put out is about being positive. The question I've been asked so many times is, how did I stay positive through this process? And so there's a couple of tricks and techniques that I was told as a little boy to employ, and I've employed them all the time through my entire life. So when a roadblock happens, how do you get around that?
Well, I look forward to that video, and I must say, I always thought if I would ever interview you, we'd be talking about fitness, but I'm glad that we're able to speak about something much more important. Thank you so much for your time today, Hal.
My pleasure. Thank you very much for having me on.
All right, you take care. That's Hal Johnson, fitness icon, and we'll get this posted online for all of our viewers to see. Much more BT to come.